While the last two mega disinvestment offers failed to garner good response from the market, government is now betting on its last offering for the year, National Mineral Development Corporation. One of the largest iron ore producers and the largest mining company in the country, NMDC's follow-on public offer will hit the market on March 10th. NMDC is hoping to raise over 11,000 crore rupees from its FPO. Government will sell 8.38% of its stake, reducing its shareholding to 90%. The price band for NMDC's follow-on public offer has been fixed at ₹300 to ₹350 per share, a discount of 12.9 to 25.3% from its current market price. The public sector entity will raise 33.22 crore equity shares with a discount of 5% for the retail investors. The company is hoping for an overwhelming market response due to its rich cash reserves and huge mineral deposits.
It doesn't only have financial reserves, it has mineral reserves, and therefore the value of the company, the value of the enterprise is quite substantial, quite predictable, so far as the natural resource company is concerned. Therefore, NMDC has been standing on a very, very different footing. It has good natural resources, good productivity, and obviously good cash reserves and good market.
But many brokerage houses are not happy with the price band. They say that the stock will remain an underperformer.
It went from 300 to 450 and again 450 to 550. We had a target of 550, it got achieved. And thereafter, what we have seen is more of a distribution pattern. We might see a level of around 350 or so, perhaps lower. But NMDC is pure setup for a trap, I would say.
Despite discounted prices, the poor response to the FPOs has led to questions about government's ability to meet its disinvestment target. Of its target of 25,000 crore rupees for this fiscal, government has garnered 882.51 crore rupees from Rural Electrification Corporation, 8,480 crore rupees from National Thermal Power Corporation, much below the expected response. Earlier it raised 2,012 crore rupees from National Hydropower Corporation and 2,247 crore rupees from Oil India Limited. The government so far has raised 13,621.51 crore rupees, and now the responsibility of bridging the gap of 11,378 crore rupees lies on NMDC's FPO.
Look at the individual company and the circumstances of that company. It may want to raise money for its own expansion programs, and government may be piggyback. In that case, it does happen. It's more than 10%, as it could happen.
The government is hoping that the market response will be better next year to help reach the bigger target of ₹40,000 crore. Himani Kaushik, Bloomberg UTV, New Delhi.